Hello everyone, welcome back to another video from Bioholic. Today in this particular video, I am going to talk about the phylum Porifera or the sponges. So let's begin. At first, we need to know what is sponge. So sponges are the simplest animals among all the animals. And sponges are asymmetrical aquatic animals that have a variety of colors, shapes and sizes. Although sponges do not resemble more familiar animals, they carry on the same life processes as all animals. Many are bright shades of red, orange, yellow and green. And most of the animals live in the marine biomes, but about 150 species can be found in freshwater environments. Also, the sponges are known to be a very rich sources of bioactive compounds, especially the secondary metabolites. Okay? Now, let's see what are the characteristic features of the sponges. So, at the very first, the sponges are pore bearers. So, the sponges are classified in the invertebrate phylum Porifera, which means pore bearer. And the sponges are mainly Sicily organisms. Sicily means the lack of motility. Because most adult sponges cannot travel in search of food, they get their food by a process called the filter feeding. So the filter feeding is a method in which an organism feeds by filtering small particles of food from the water that pass by or through some part of the organism. Okay? And let's see the direction of the water flow through the sponge. So water flows in through the pore cells and out through the osculum, which is an epithelial like cells or pore cells, amebocyte spicules. Okay? Now the second thing is the body form. So sponges have a water transport of canal system because sponges have a porous body and minute pores present in their body wall through which water enters into the body is known as ostia, or the singular form is ostium. So these ostia lead into a single central and spacious cavity called the spongocele, and the canals it present and the spongocele are internally lined by a flagellated cell which is known as guanocyte. So this is a very important characters of sponges. Now let's have a look into this image. Here the guanocyte is shown. Okay, now the third characteristic feature is osculum. And I have already discussed about that the water flows in through the pore cell and out through the osculum. So let's see the picture. And osculum is an excretory structure with a large opening to the outside. So waste is product diffused into the water and water is pumped out through the osculum, carrying away with it the sponge's wastes. Okay? Now the fourth one is the cellular organization. So for some sponge species, if you took a living sponge and put it through a sieve, not only would the sponge's cell be alive and separated out, but these cells would come together to form a new sponges. It can take several weeks for the sponge cells to recognize themselves. So many biologists hypothesize that sponges evolved directly from colonial flagellated protists such as volvox. More importantly, the sponges exhibit a major step in the evolution of animals. The change from unicellular life to a division of labor among groups of organized cells. And now the reproduction. So, sponges can reproduce asexually or sexually. Depending on the species, asexual reproduction can be by budding, fragmentation, or the formation of gametes. So an external growth known as bud can form on a sponge's body. And if a bud drops off, it can float away, settle and grow into a new sponge. Sometimes buds do not break off and then the colony of sponges forms. And often fragments of a sponge break off and grow into new sponges. And sometimes some freshwater sponges reproduce seed-like particles called as gametes in the fall when waters cool. The adult sponges die over the winter, but the gametes can survive and grow into new sponges in the spring when the water gets warm. Now here are some images of the asexual reproduction in the sponges. You can see that an outgrowth arises at the base of the sponge's body and which forms the bud, and the bud falls off and break out from the parent and get attached to the new substratum and forms the new sponges. Okay, and here is the fragmentation where you can see the sponge is split into or broken into pieces or the fragments, which in turn gets into a new clones formation and attached to a surface and begin to grow. It means it gives birth to new sponges. Okay. Now the sexual reproduction. So most sponges reproduce sexually. Some sponges have separate sexes, but most sponges are hermaphrodites. So a hermaphrodite is an animal that can produce both eggs and sperm. Eggs and sperm form from the amebocytes. During the reproduction, sperm released from one sponge can be carried by water currents to the another sponge, where fertilization can occur. Okay. Now here are some images of sexual reproduction. So the fertilization in sponges may be either external or internal. A few sponges have external fertilization. So the fertilization that occurs outside of the animal's body is known as external fertilization. So most sponges have internal fertilization, in which eggs inside the animal's body are fertilized by the sperm carried out in the sponge with water currents. In sponges, the collar cells collect and transfer sperm into the amebocytes, and the amebocytes then transport the sperm into the ripe eggs or the mature eggs. Okay. So the last characteristics is skeleton. So almost all sponges possess an internal skeleton, which is known as endoskeleton. It supports the body of the sponges and it comprises of spicules or sponges fiber or the both. Okay, you can see this in this picture, and these are the structural elements of the skeleton of sponge. Further, the spicules may be calcareous or siliceous on the basis of the material they are made up of. So the calcareous means the made up of calcium, and the siliceous means the made up of silicon. Okay. Now here is one interesting fact about the porifera. So some sponges host photosynthesizing microorganisms just like the cyanobacteria and green algae as endosymbionts, and these alliances often produce more food and oxygen, about 3 times more, and then they consume. So these are very beneficial for them, and such contribution of these alliances to their habitats resources are significant along the Australia's Great Barrier Reef. So these are the examples. One is cycon. Another is Spongia, which is a freshwater sponge, and the next one is the Euspongia, which is a bath sponge. Okay. So these are all about the phylum Porifera. We will meet on the next Wednesday with a new phylum. Okay. So now if you have any doubts or questions related to today's lecture, then ask me in the comment section below. And if you want to do your self-assessment, then have a look into the description box. I have provided the link for the self-assessment test. So that's all for today. If you like this video, then give it a big thumbs up and share it with others. And if you are new here, then please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon for further notification of our upcoming videos. So thanks for watching, and till then, take care and keep watching BioHolic.